dancers, welcome back to my channel. Today we're going to talk about a pregnancy-safe ballet class that's going to be a slow flow for those of you who are in your first, even in your third trimester, and just want to move a little bit and not feel like you're causing harm to your baby. But first, before we get started, make sure you always like, subscribe, and share my channel to other dancers who you think would benefit. Okay, so first things first, I've compiled this class based off of personal experience and data and research that I've pulled from sources like the Mayo Clinic, Healthline, and even my OBGYN talking to her. So the first thing I want to talk about is precautions to take. So when you do ballet class, there's a lot of different movement changes, and you want to be very aware of your body temperature and your blood pressure. When we perform a step like a cambre forward, that's actually going to lower our blood pressure. So if you're somebody who runs a little bit on the low side with blood pressure, you're gonna probably wanna avoid going forward and back whenever you're performing ballet class, especially in the first trimester. For me personally, my blood pressure ended up dropping a lot more when I was pregnant. So I noticed when I would do a cambre forward or backwards, because of that change in blood pressure, I would get stars in my eyes and I would get really dizzy immediately. So avoiding those motions or just taking caution with those motions is really important. The other thing that might block you from doing a cambre forward is once the baby starts to grow, it might actually feel like somebody's fist is in your gut stopping you from bending forward. Sudden jerky movements like grand battement or a grand jeté. So because our body is releasing relaxin, our ligaments and our cartilage are all loosening up, which puts our bones at greater risk for injury. When you make sudden jerky movements, obviously you can tear and shear muscles or ligaments, and so we don't want to do that. By avoiding those movements that are sudden and jerky and making them just a little bit different in quality can really help you keep your body safe and your baby safe during your pregnancy. And I don't say, you know, avoid grand battements at all costs, but we're going to change the quality of it and the height of it a little bit to be more comfortable on your body. And as far as grand allegro goes, just take it as you feel. If you're somebody who's doing grand allegro all the time before pregnancy and you don't feel any different when you do it in the first or second trimester, then that's fine. As long as you're not somebody who's at a high risk for falling, then you should be just fine. Hot environments. So making sure that you're in an environment that is not too warm, like a hot yoga sauna, anything that is gonna be really, really warm. You don't wanna perform exercise in these environments because you're actually going to take blood supply away from the uterus and away from the fetus. So you wanna make sure that your body temperature is regulated and you're cooled down at all time, especially during the first trimester, and that can be helped by drinking lots of water and, again, managing your environment. Extensions above 90. So this is gonna be kind of a personal thing, but for me, I know that extensions above 90 right now are painful for me, and normally they wouldn't be. So because of that round ligament expanding and relaxing going through your body, you're putting, you know, your whole body is at higher risk for injury right now because things are just shifting and moving around, making room for the baby. So for me, whenever I put my leg above 90 in the front, it feels like somebody's compressing my stomach in the front. And then whenever I take my leg above 90 to the back, it is so different the way that it feels in arabesque. It almost feels like, you know, you can feel the baby's there almost, where it's just blocking your extension. You can't fully extend back to what you normally would. I just feel very blocked right now. So I don't even try to force it anymore. I just keep my extensions like at 90 or below and just keep them nice and solid where they are. Because right now I don't dance professionally, so I'm not really worried about getting my legs crazy up high. I'm just worried about kind of moving and keeping my body in maintenance, circulation, good blood flow to the baby, those things. Jumping, okay. Jumping like petit allegro is okay as long as you have balance, you have safe footwear and safe flooring. Some people, I've heard wives' tales where, you know, jostling the fetus or jumping up and down, stuff like that can hurt the baby. But everyone that is a medical expert that I've talked to about this has said, it is okay for me to do small jumps as long as I'm not at risk for falling. The biggest thing is that medical experts do not want you to put yourself at risk for falling. So grand allegro, obviously there's a little more risk there. And like I said previously, if you're somebody who's dancing in a company every day and you're doing grand allegro all the time, this might not affect you, but somebody who's an adult beginner or, you know, an adult intermediate dancer or somebody who just does it occasionally like me now, you might not want to do grand allegro while you're pregnant because you might feel a lot different. Turning in the first trimester. Turns in the first trimester can be devastating to morning sickness. If you're somebody who gets motion sick in the car, you get migraines, or you have morning sickness and nausea, turning is not going to help you at all. So I would avoid turns at all costs if you can. If you're a teacher and you have, you know, a demonstrator, try to have somebody else demonstrate for you. Or, you know, if you're in a company and you're really having issues, you know, hopefully your director will understand why. Stretching while lying on your back. So you don't want to do any kind of stretches after the first trimester when you're lying on your back. So you always want to make sure that the blood flow to the baby is adequate. And in that position, it cuts off the blood flow. So you want to make sure that you're stretching your hamstrings and other things like that in side lying or just a different position. Round ligament pain. So we already kind of talked about this. It occurs because of the expansion of the uterus and the abdomen because getting room for baby. This pain can feel a lot like muscle spasms, and I noticed it so prevalently when I would take my legs above 90 when I was doing grand battement or développé, and it would feel like my psoas were just like contracting up and just gripping constantly. So that was when I decided, I said, okay, no more extensions above 90, 90 or below, that's good enough for me, because I don't want to have any kind of discomfort or anything that could possibly harm the baby. So now that we've gone over all these precautions and just kind of gotten a little bit of background knowledge, let's jump in and take class. Okay, we'll start in first position with a plié combination, and we'll just take it nice and easy. So we're just gonna go demi-plié and stretch, roll through the feet and lower, and demi-plié and up and tendu to second. And second, demi-plié and stretch, roll up through the feet and lower. Now we'll take a grand plié, nice and gentle in second position. If your body says you're not ready for that right now, then that's okay. Just do another demi. We're gonna go into fifth position, avoiding fourth today to put less stress on our bodies. And we're gonna go demi-plié and stretch and rise up and lower. No grand plié here, we'll just do another demi and roll through the feet, coming up and lower. Stretch into the bar to stretch out those obliques because that always feels good. And stretch away from the bar in fifth and come back down. And that will be our first combination.
Thank you. Next, we're going to turn the bar back to the side because we will do both sides for a grand battement. Now, as I talked about before, avoiding jerky movements is very important during this time. So we're going to actually do more of a strengthening exercise for your pelvis and your legs rather than worry about what the technical actual performance of a grand battement is in classical ballet terms. So from first position again, we're going to come up on 5, 6, 7, 8. You're going to go slide, lift, hold, tendu, close. Slide, lift, and hold, and tendu, close. Slide, and lift, and hold, and tendu, close. Slide, and lift, and hold, and tendu, close. Now, every time you guys do your grand battements, I almost want you to think about doing a kegel as you're hitting the top. And I know if you are pregnant, you probably know how to do a kegel, which is like bearing down on your abdomen and sucking everything up in the low, low, low abdominal region. And this is gonna help support your legs, avoid you from stressing out ligaments and tendons, and it's also gonna get you stronger for childbirth. As you guys might be able to tell, I'm kind of bearing down a little bit more on my pelvis when I'm holding it. I'm really trying to isolate that kegel so that I can really get that pelvic floor working. Other side. To wrap up today's session, we are going to do a couple of exercises and stretches that are safe for baby and you. Start by grabbing a yoga ball and place it underneath your low back and walk your feet out a little bit. Your back is naturally going to want to arch here, and that's okay because that's going to be your starting position. Place your hands below the bones of your hips, and you're going to start in this arched position. Breathe in. And breathe out, bring your hips to neutral and perform your kegel. Interlax, arch. And if this bothers your neck, you can lay your head down on the ball too. And perform your tilt and kegel. Exhale. And relax. And again, perform your tilt and kegel. And down. And again, tilt and kegel. And down. One more time, you guys. Good job. Nice and gentle. And down. All right, slide off of the ball. Come to facing your ball and then let it walk out in front of you and bend forward. Hold for 30 seconds. Side. We're going to start in child's pose and push up on all fours and back again. And up on all fours and again back shoulders to go into cat and cow. Next, grab your yoga mat and just lay it out, rolled up a little bit in front of you. Place your knees on it for comfort. Use your bar if you need to for just a little more support. And you're going to lean, stretching out the front of the abdominals back. If you feel stable and you're like you're not going to fall, you can place your hands behind your head. But for me, I feel a little more comfortable today just with my hands in front of me. Come back up. And repeat back. And back up. Shake the head out. Now go ahead and take the mat and put it down on the floor. And then put one hand on the bar with one leg in front of you. Balances everything with pregnancy. Keep the back up as tall as you can and push forward into a regular lunge to stretch the psoas out. Remember, we want to be gentle on the psoas, so going down into the splits, stuff like that, overstretches, not great for this time. And if you want a little deeper of a stretch, you can always stretch into the bar. And up. Go ahead and switch to the other side. Back straight and lean forward. And deep breathing into the psoas muscle where all that expansion is happening in the front of the hips. And come back up. Go ahead and sit down with your legs crisscrossed like this. And you're just going to take a nice torso rotation, keeping the spine long, and hold. And back to center, and to the other side. Now, take the ball and put it behind your back. And you're not going to do an excessive back bend, but you're just going to lean back in this position and allow the upper abdominals to stretch out. Hold here as long as you want. This feels so good. And slowly come back up when you're ready. All right, dancers, I hope you guys had a relaxing time and learned something new that can help your pregnancy and just took a nice slow flow class to warm your body up and make you feel like you're not just sitting around all day. I know for me, there's a lot of days when I just want to sit around and it just feels good to do something, even if it's not like what I'm used to doing. Remember to be patient with your body. It's growing and making a child, so you don't have to be full activity like you normally would be. Remember to subscribe to my channel and check out my veronicakballet.com website where I have private one-on-one training, lots of different options as far as classes for groups go, and even a platform where you can access my classes at any time. I hope you have an amazing pregnancy and I wish the best to you and your new little one.